Guys, how are you? I'm really excited. I'm Wei from Revolution and the Rake magazine, as you know. We've interviewed many watchmaking icons here, incredible innovators in the watch industry, everyone from my friend Richard Mille to Thierry Stern recently at the Patek exhibition here in Singapore. But today, I'm super excited to interview a true icon, Mr. Kikue Ibe, the creator and chief engineer and innovator behind one of the most iconic watches in the world, the Casio G-Shock. Sir, how are you?
Yeah, thank you very much.
Very pleasure to see you. So I want to tell you guys a little bit about why I love the G-Shock. So as a Singaporean man, I was required to come back to Singapore and perform 2.5 years of military service. During the very first standard obstacle course that I ever participated in, before that I had already prepared for the Army. I had bought myself a Swiss watch, a very rugged Swiss watch, one that was not supposed to break under any form of pressure. I put it on and I did the standard obstacle course. So I jumped over the walls, I climbed the rope, I went underneath the barbed wire. I think I actually fell in the barbed wire at some point. And after everything was over, I looked at my watch and it was destroyed. The glass was cracked, the bezel had come off. I think one of the hands, the second hand had come off, and one of the chronograph hands had come off as well. So I looked at my sergeant and I showed him my watch and he said, "You're an idiot. Just go buy a G-Shock, it will never break." And that's when I was introduced to the G-Shock. So my first question for you, Ibe-san, is 36 years ago, when you were creating the prototype of the most shock-resistant watch in the world, when you were throwing your prototype out of the toilet from the third floor window of your office, I know you were interested in creating something that was very performance-driven, but did you think you would be creating something that 36 years later would become such an icon?
全く想像してませんでした。で、ここまで、ロングラン、できたのは、メディアさんの力が非常に大きい、と思ってます。で、特に今日、ラッキーにも、ウェイコさんと、インタビュー、レボリューションの、インタビューを、受けることができて、とても、感動していると同時に、感謝しています。
Well, that's very kind of you. One of the things that I love about G-Shock, it was one of the first brands to collaborate with other brands to broaden the appeal and connect the watch to other universes. And one of my favorite watches, for example, is the collaboration you did with Murakami. Mm. This was an amazing watch. And this watch, incredibly now, in the aftermarket, I think it's selling for like $20,000, which I think is something quite incredible. Another watch I love is the Bathing Ape collaboration as well. Where did these ideas for collaboration come from, and what was the purpose?
まず、我々の判断基準として、ウィンウィンの関係になることを大前提にしています。で、コラボレーションをやったとこの方とはいつもいい関係を持つことができてます。で、全てのモデルが私にとっては素晴らしいモデルだと思っております。
Has he kept any of the collaboration models?
私にとっては、まあ、全て、どれも優劣つけがたい、素晴らしいモデルだと思ってます。
Good answer. So, Ibe-san, the Full Metal G-Shocks and also the MTG G-Shocks, they've been very interesting models in that they have moved the price of the G-Shock much higher into the luxury category. Why is this important to you?
まず2つ考えています。で、1つは、若い方にも上質感のものをぜひ味わっていただきたいということと、もう1つは、スイス時計コレクターの方にもぜひ、手につけていただきたいという2つのラインを我々は考えています。
Well, I think you've been very successful because I have many friends who are collecting very complicated watches, even Richard Mille, and they all love the Full Metal G-Shock.
Thank you very much.
And especially they all love the titanium G-Shock. Yeah. Tell me, why did you decide to create the Full Metal in titanium? Why titanium? What is interesting to you about this material?
まず G-Shock は性能、スタイル、色、材質というふうに常に進化を重ねてます。そんな中で軽いという材質でまずチタンを今回選んでます。で、そのチタンに傷がつきにくい表面処理を加えるということと、今手にしていただいているこれはレーザー加工という全く新しい手法でカモフラージュ柄をつけるという斬新なアイデアで開発できた素晴らしい商品になってます。
I wear it when I'm jogging.
Yeah, good.
Is it possible for me to ask what is the surface treatment?
レーザーというまずダイヤモンドのような硬い DLC というダイヤモンドライクカーボン。
Yes. Diamond-like carbon.
とっても硬い傷がつきにくい表面処理をしてます。Right. でその後にレーザーで小さなこういうドット加工。
Which is incredible.
Yeah,
yes, this, I love this. This is fantastic.
Yeah.
And I noticed that Casio is also now experimenting with some other materials. For example, carbon fiber. Yeah. Is carbon fiber something interesting for you for G-Shock?
カーボンは、プラスチックのように軽くてメタルのように強い第三の素材というふうに言われてます。で、カーボンを使った G-Shock はもうすでに発売されてて、この B5000 では、今のところカーボンで作るという計画はありません。
Is it because eBay-san feels as if the carbon looks too similar to plastic?
いや、特にはないんですけれども、今この B5000 というのはステンレス、チタンというので、発売した、ばかりです。で、これをどれだけ我々は、認知していただけるかというところに一番のパワーを使ってます。プラスプラスチックのように軽くメタルのように強い新しい素材という位置づけをしています。
Wow, fantastic. So instead of carbon fiber, he's more interested to work on this. But the new material is carbon or not carbon?
第三の素材をカーボン。
It's carbon reinforced plastic. Plastic, carbon inside.
Yeah, yeah, yes. そうです。
Yes.
プラスチックの中にカーボンを中に入れてると思っていただいて。
Carbon reinforced plastic.
Perfect.Perfect, perfect.
Thank you.
This is very
no, but fantastic. Yeah,
yeah. This is
fantastic.
Very nice. No. So, 私の代わりになると思ってください。カシオに来れば。
So what Ibe-san is saying is when I asked him about would he be interested to do a carbon fiber G-Shock, which I think we would all love to own, he said actually he's more interested in a new category of material, which is a combination between plastic and carbon, which is called carbon reinforced plastic, which we've seen Richard Mille actually is using and a few others are using as well in F1 and so on. And this is a material that is the same lightness as plastic, but with the same strength of metal. Very exciting.Are we very far away from seeing this watch?
Yeah, もうカーボンの G-Shock はすでに発売されてます。で、これからも新製品が開発される計画をしてます。
Wow, very exciting. Yeah. On the last year for the 35th anniversary, you showed a sapphire crystal watch.
Yeah, yeah.
It's very beautiful.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Thank you very
much. Would you ever consider to make this in production?
ありがとうございます。で、残念ながら、オールサファイアの G-Shock はコンクリートに叩きつける実験で、まだ、現在割れてます。で、それをまず開発しなきゃいけないのでもう少し、商品化までは、お時間がかかると思ってます。
Okay, no problem. We have to find new category of sapphire.
考えたことがあまりにも非常識すぎたということを今自分で反省しています。発表しなければよかったなと後悔しています。
But the gold watch, you can, does it pass all the tests?
合格したので発売することができました。で、シンガポールでも買ってくださった方がいらっしゃるので、とても感謝しています。
The $70,000 gold watch.
Yeah, but yes.
Wow! Fantastic! Bravo! It makes me happy that Singaporeans are buying it, you know? People often talk about the G-Shock from a functional perspective.But to me, it is also a design icon, one of the most beautifully designed objects. What is his design inspiration, and what for him are some of his favorite design objects?
まず必ず物にはその性能機能を表現するスタイル、カラーリングという要素が必ずあると思ってます。例えばボタンを押しやすくするだとか、そういうところに丈夫さとそれを体現するスタイルというところに我々は一番力を入れてます。で特にシンガポールのプラナカンデザイン のカラーリング、あれは私は素晴らしい色使いだと思って、いいものだなというふうに思ってます。
Very nice.
Yeah.
Yes. You have mentioned in the past that you dream to make a G-Shock for firemen that you can go into the fire with.
Also, you dream of having a G-Shock that a shy man and a shy woman can pass each other and the watch will help them to meet each other. What is your dream G-Shock?
まず誰でも自由に宇宙に行ける時代が、来ると思ってます。で、宇宙空間は地球上にない厳しい環境になってます。で、そこで、私と私の友達の宇宙人の太郎君と、G-Shock は今後こうあるべきだねっていう、今みたいなディスカッションができたら、最高だなと妄想しております。
Both are wearing G-Shocks. Last question. Do you own a mechanical watch?And if you, what is your favorite mechanical watch?
まず、機械式は伝統の重みがある時計で、素晴らしい商品だと思ってます。ただ私の今のミッションは、時計を進化させることが、自分のミッションですので、機械式時計は、今のところ持ってないし、持つという計画もありません。
Well, you...
How many pieces of mechanical watch?
Me?
Yes.
Maybe 50.
Whoa! Great.
But G-Shock also.
Yeah. Thank you very much.
My wife also, but I don't know where she's standing. Ibe-san,
thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
It was a real pleasure. Thank you very much.